John Lewis never accepted the status quo.
We march today for jobs and freedom.
He spent his life fighting for equity and inclusion. He saw students as leaders. He threw his support behind those seeking to build thriving communities in which all people are valued equally.
John Lewis helped pave the way for the Civil Rights Act of 1964.
And the Voting Rights Act of 1965.
Lewis served 17 terms in the House of Representatives and later became known as the Conscience of Congress.
It is a great honor to name College 10 as John R. Lewis College. This is a wonderful moment for our campus, attesting to our deep commitment to help students become agents for justice, equity, inclusivity, and social change.
I think it's fitting given his history of activism and the history of activism at UC Santa Cruz.
For me personally, I think it makes me feel seen and it makes me feel heard.
It is the first college to be named after a person of color.
John R. Lewis College is the youngest of the residential colleges here at UC Santa Cruz, founded in 2002. It is the home of about 1,500 undergraduate students.
Over the two decades it's existed, it's had a robust series of programs that support students as positive change agents in our society and our world.
Division of Social Sciences and John R. Lewis College have been partners since the college's beginning. This opportunity will amplify and expand our existing programs rooted in social justice alongside our curious and creative students.
In 1940, John Lewis was born in rural Alabama in the very heart of segregation. That was the environment he was born in. But he was also born in a positive family environment, in a positive Black community environment. In 1961, John Lewis took part in what became known as the Freedom Rides. The Freedom Riders were men and women, Black and white, who got on buses to travel interstate across state lines, which was forbidden by segregationist law in the South, and to open up public transportation for the public. In 1963, John Lewis helped to organize the Student Nonviolent Coordinating Committee. It was people working together to use nonviolent tactics and nonviolent beliefs to struggle against an extremely oppressive, dangerous, and brutal system. The March on Washington was the march for jobs and freedom. I was there, the atmosphere was electric and it was peaceful. Martin Luther King gave the beautiful visionary dream. John Lewis gave us this really down-to-earth grassroots emphasis on economic justice. And the two of them together complement each other in a wonderful way. In 1965, the march that resulted in Bloody Sunday was to take thousands of people from Selma, Alabama, across the Edmund Pettus Bridge to the state capital of Montgomery, the heart of segregation, to protest the denial of voting rights to Black people. They were blocked by the governor of Alabama and his police. The police then suddenly charged them and started beating them with these long nightsticks, and they were beaten nearly to death. In 1986, John Lewis ran for the House of Representatives. John Lewis won that election. When he was in the House of Representatives, John Lewis played a major role in pushing for health care reform, for example.
No one should be denied health care. There can be no discrimination.
For educational development, for securing the Voting Rights Act, he maintained a persistent pattern of compassionate politics. He held his seat in the House of Representatives until his death in 2020 at the age of 80.
Our goal is to teach students what it means to be social change agents. That comes with an understanding of history and legacy, of the hard work of those who have come before us.
This starts right when they arrive here and take their first class in the core course, where they learn about issues of racism, homophobia, sexism, xenophobia, and other forms of discrimination and oppression in our society, and grapple with their own positionality.
I really loved my core class. I loved my professor, and it just embodied all the ideas that I agree with.
They move towards different programs that they're interested in, whether it's from facilitating a class through the Social Justice Issues Workshop to actually organizing and implementing an entire day-long conference called Practical Activism.
One of the programs in the making is the Good Trouble Academy. The Good Trouble Academy will host the myriad of opportunities that our students have to engage with our theme of social justice and community, both inside and outside of the classroom.
The naming provides institutional longevity for the progressive ideas that he so embodied.
Congressman Lewis was very ill, but very determined until the end. He wanted to leave a message. He wanted to encourage others. He wanted to inspire good troublemaking. The key is don't ever give up. It's not going to happen overnight. Be prepared. Stay focused. Do what you know to be the right thing to do. And to the extent that we do that, we are continuing his legacy.